only about 0.00003% of all YouTube users is subscribed to my channel. Let's change that. Subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any more of my content. Enjoy the video. All right, what's up? So my friend Mook posted this respawn thing earlier about the new season of Apex and what's coming. I think it's the dev diary. So I wanted to see what it is about because I have like opened Apex Legends for like 20 minutes. No, I opened Apex Legends. I played some arenas the other night for a good maybe like 2 hours. And you know, I was having fun, you know, but I haven't been playing Apex in such a long time. But I want to see if, you know, it makes me want to like dabble in like play the BR a little bit more, but let's see what it's about. It's a 4-minute video and it's just, I guess it's talking about what's going to be
it's time to change the game.
I don't know if I'm going to even care about any of these changes or if there are changes, what's going to be a new thing? I don't know what makes a good season.
Hey, I'm Steve Ferreira, game director on Apex Legends.
And I am Evan Nikolic, the design director on Apex Legends.
And we're here to share details about our new Apex season, Revelry.
All right.
As the game and the community has grown, we've had millions of players join the game. And with that, they've gotten better and better. This season, we're going to shake it up. We're going to reset the playing field. We're gonna make it more accessible than it's ever been. Everything is safe. So everything you know and love, there may be changes coming down the line.
Are you making it easier for me to play people in the game?
We're very excited about Legend Meta this season, and we're gonna be doing things a little differently than we have before.
As we're going into this year, we're taking a pause on adding a legend to the roster, and we're gonna focus on the legends you know and love.
And we're getting already getting reworked.
A rework to our class system.
We're doing that through Legend Classes Remastered.
Is that gonna?
We're gonna create 5 classes this season: Assault, Skirmisher, Recon.
I did hear about this.
So each class is gonna have a unique, meaningful perk. In some instances, be able to interact with new loot bins. The way you interact with Recon beacons is gonna change, and you'll have a new way to revive teammates. With the classes and perks, we're looking to create new and compelling ways to play the game and create new team compositions. But then we're also going to deep dive into existing legends, giving a few buffs and a few nerfs, you know, a few that we're going to touch are Lifeline, Seer, Wraith, and more. We're really committing to this new philosophy of evolving the game.
Do not blink, legend. You do not want to miss this.
We've got a lot of new things coming, and first we've got TDM. Team Deathmatch is going to be ready to play on season launch.
We took a hard look at Arenas in its current state. We feel Arenas is missing the mark for our players, and it's not achieving the team's goals for it, too. That's why we've made the difficult decision to sunset Arenas at this time.
No! What? Arenas is cool? Arenas is cool? But Team Deathmatch does sound pretty cool, though. Like, Team Deathmatch. Arenas is good, though! What's wrong with Arenas?
Unrun and now Team Deathmatch are making them available to you all times throughout the season. And so we're super excited to introduce Mixtape. Our goal with Mixtape is to give players a chance to jump in, play a variety of game modes, and allow them to master combat. As seasons go on, we're going to be taking a look at what we can add to Mixtape, maybe bring some variety. We're going to start the season with Team Deathmatch for the first 3 weeks, and then Mixtape will be available shortly thereafter.
I'm definitely going to play Team Deathmatch. And I want to see what Team Deathmatch will be about.
Well, it's been a long time since we've had a weapon added to the game, so we're very excited to bring in the Nemesis. So it's a new energy weapon, and we're tuning this one hot, and we're looking to unseat the old standbys, the R301 and the Flatline.
Yo, y'all going to have a crazy new weapon?
It's never been a better time to join the game. From a first-time player experience, we're overhauling everything. We're going to be looking at our firing range. We're going to be introducing dummy challenges. We're going to introduce stat tracking. And as a new player, we're going to introduce bots into our matches to ease players into the experience and allow them to get their feet under them before they get thrown into the hardcore BR competition. Overall, we're going to create a better...
Some people are going to be mad about that.
And try
the reason why...
In the game and start
getting... Okay, so about bots, like people are going to be mad about bots. I don't know if... I don't trust no company to not put bots everywhere, because once they introduce bots into the game, there's no telling. We'll see. There's no telling what that might do later on, because like I don't know how they're gonna work that out. Because with Fortnite, right? Fortnite, they introduce bots. When you first landed, and the first time I was, I came in into an encounter with a bot, I was like, at first I thought I was doing something, right? But then I was like, nah, this too easy. What's going on? I'm never able to like just mow through people like this. Then you get to the point where it's like you see that somebody is a bot, and you're like, okay, this person is not they got bots in the game. And then that makes you question everything else later on in the game, where it's like, is that person a bot or is that a bad player? Like you don't know. Sometimes you do, like sometimes in Fortnite you just see the people that are just like breaking walls or whatever, and then like you run up on them, you're just like, oh, this person's breaking a wall. You run up on them and they're just continue breaking the wall. They don't try to do anything, they don't turn around, try to shoot you. So like it's weird. So like it's gonna be a little weird. We'll see how it goes. Hopefully there's like a cutoff where they don't put bots in the game at all after a certain point, like after you've played a certain amount of games or something like that. But like having bots in the game, I don't trust them to not have bots in like later in places with or like at higher tiers where it's like, oh, you got your feet under you now, you're a little better at the game, but you know, I don't know, we only had 50 players enter the game, now we're gonna fill the rest with bots, like, you know what I mean? So hopefully they don't do that.
Getting in some reps. It wouldn't be an anniversary season without a brand new anniversary collection event featuring all
collection events are ass. If you don't have money and you're broke, collection events are ass. I'm pretty sure, right? Like you can't really earn anything, can you? You can't earn anything at a collection event. You have to buy this stuff, right? Don't you have to buy the... If I'm wrong, please correct me, because I'm pretty sure you can't earn anything from the collection event. You have... The only way to earn things from the collection event is to get a job and make some money and then spend that money on the collection event, right? I think that's how you earn stuff.
All new community content, but also a celebration in-game. So every map in rotation is going to have anniversary dressing, and we're bringing back a fan favorite that you'll find out when the game goes live.
Oh, they bring back the first map.
Really excited about Apex this season.
Right.
And we've got a ton of new content that the team is very excited to share with all of you.
On behalf of the entire Apex Legends team, we want to take a moment to thank you for creating all the amazing moments in Apex over the last 4 years.
We make this game for you, our players, and we can't wait to try and surprise you again this year. So we're really excited for everyone to get into the game on February 14th when Revelry drops. Thank you for 4 incredible years.
February 14th.
To an exciting year of Apex Legends. We'll see you in the game.
All right. I guess I'll try some Apex on the 14th. What day is that? Let me see what day that is real quick. Let me look at my calendar. We got Dark and Darker from the 6th. To the 10th, I believe it is this week, and then the 14th. What is on the 13th? Dark and Darker ends on the 13th. The 14th, right after that we got Apex. We'll put a Apex Legends new. Start using this a lot more. Apex Legends new season. Here we go. All right. All right. Well, that's about it. All right. Peace.